Welcome to the BioBalance Healthcast, episode number 447. Why do you only use pellets in your practice? BioBalance Health features conversations about anti-aging medicine. Your hosts are Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health, and a leading expert in treating symptoms of aging, and Brett Newcomb, a licensed professional counselor. Dr. Maupin and Brett are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about testosterone replacement therapy for women, and Got Testosterone, the newly released book for men that helps men choose the most effective and safe form of T replacement. These books are available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health in St. Louis and in Kansas City. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients. Why do you only use pellets in your practice? It's a question you get asked all the time, mm-hmm. and especially by other physicians who are aware that testosterone and estrogen can be replaced in a half a dozen different mm-hmm. ways, that people can get that, that with the different ways there are concerns or issues. How do you mm-hmm. get through the blood-brain barrier? Mm-hmm. Do you put it on the skin? Does it rub off on the baby mm-hmm. or the wife or the mm-hmm. husband? You know, and mm-hmm. will that affect them? And how do you get a consistent amount in the bloodstream, which is what you're trying to achieve mm-hmm. when you replace.
And you're not trying to share it.
Yes, and you're not trying to share it, spread it through the neighborhood.
There was an episode on Doc Martin where he had been, of course, it's Britain, so he had been using estrogen,
uh-huh.
and he'd been giving one of the ladies in town estrogen cream to put in the vagina.
Yeah.
So she did that. And then a lot of the men in town were getting man boobs, you know, and belly fat. And so yeah. so they were going to the same doctor and saying...
They were getting intense contact with estrogen.
Right, right. Well, yeah. So if you use vaginal estrogen, and that's a way of administering it, you don't want to put that in there right before you have sex, because that's something that can be rubbed off. And I mean, it was a funny, you know, circumstance, partially because so many of the guys in town had this male breast problem. And so she was actually having a lot more fun than she should have been having.
Share the love.
So in any case, but that was, it's a true finding, you know, yeah. it's kind of interesting how they pick their subjects. Yeah. But I always told women who I gave vaginal estrogen to not use it before intercourse, use it afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't use it every night. So it's not, or in general, you don't, but some people who get their replacement that way, you have to use every night.
Mm-hmm.
So there are lots of options with estrogen, but I've used all those options since the 80s. I've given people all those options except pellets. I started pellets in 2002 when I tried everything that I've been giving other people and it didn't work. And so I had to use pellets put under the skin, slowly releasing my estrogen and testosterone so that I would feel like myself, because that's what my ovary used to do. So one of the reasons I use pellets is it replicates the ovary more than any other form of hormone.
So it provides the right amount of estrogen or testosterone that you need, but it's an on-demand system by the body. When the mm-hmm. body needs it, it's there, it pulls it out.
You're always getting some because it's mm-hmm. blood flow going by the pellet, the little pellet in your hip, and it's picking up some of it. But then if you exercise, you get more.
Mm-hmm.
And if you stay up all the time, if you don't sleep much, you get more. So I have to figure out dosages for that, but it's an on-demand system. It's a reservoir for you to pick up your hormones, both
right.
estrogen and testosterone.
So, and no other system is.
And no other system does that. So what we see in blood levels is, on a daily basis, the blood level's even. Maybe going up a little tiny bit when you need it, but in general, it doesn't really go up because you're using it as soon as you need it. Basically, the blood level stays the same. All the others go like up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And they get really high and then drop really low, and that doesn't feel very good to most of us. In fact, men would hate that,
mm-hmm.
and they do hate that when they get shots. That's what happens, only it's over a course of a few days.
It's like emotional surges.
Yeah. I mean, you get
– or hot
flashes. You're crying at lunch, and then you're having hot flashes at night. I mean,
yeah.
it's not a good way of giving your body the estrogen. It still does the good stuff.
It just doesn't feel right.
Doesn't
you don't feel
good.
Like yourself.
Right.
The way that you remember yourself.
Because
you
used shots before too, and so it's different than pellets. Pellets are,
yes,
yeah, different because they're consistent.
Mm-hmm.
The other reason I use pellets, I don't have to worry about whether my patient's going to use the entire tub of testosterone cream or estrogen cream in one day, or if they're not going
to
use it.
It's an anniversary week, and I have to go through this whole tub.
And so I'm just going to rub it all over myself, and then they get hair everywhere. So if it's testosterone and estrogen, they get bloated and swollen, and then they start to bleed from their uterus. I mean, it's sometimes it's not good to self-dose. In some folks, so that it's better that I can put in the dose that they need and they come back when they need the next dose. So those
are all
important.
I don't have to remember anything. I don't have to remember the time. You know, am I supposed to take this sequence of medicines at this time? Mm-hmm. I don't have to monitor how I'm feeling or how I'm responding.
Because you're feeling fine.
Once I've had the pellets put in, I don't have to think about it again until I start to realize I'm running out of the benefit of them four or 6 months later.
Right. So it takes all of that time consumption that you have to think about putting a cream on or putting a tab in your vagina or giving yourself a shot. I mean, all of that is gone. Mm-hmm. So three times a year or two times a year, you have to think about it, which makes it so much more like real life and not like being sick.
Yeah.
So we also have up here the complete resolution of symptoms. Mm-hmm. When I gave people estrogen cream or testosterone in Vaseline, which was how we gave it, they never felt completely better. I may have alleviated one symptom. Mm-hmm. So maybe their bottoms were not as sore when they had sex or they had better lubrication. But I didn't make their brain feel better and I didn't give them a sex drive. I mean, in general, it didn't work very well. But because it's the only thing I had
right.
That's all I could do. So the complete resolution of symptoms is what we get with pellets.
Right.
So that's another reason why I use it. And there are very few side effects and very few complications with the pellets. But I was asked to go over some of the side effects that I've experienced my practice.
And in your presentation, you talk about, because you make a statement like complete resolution of symptoms, and people that are cynical and sardonic will go, oh, yeah, right. And so you talked about, you use in your office an in-body machine to track weight, muscle weight, water weight,
fat.
Distribution fat, so that it graphically demonstrates every time a patient comes in exactly what progress they've made or haven't made, how their body is shifting. You have a symptom list that you take when they come in for their first interview with you, and then you go back over that list with them every time.
How
add
much
anything
better is
new
it?
That's come up, but remind that all of these things you complained about when you came in are no longer in your horizon.
Right.
So you're better, or are you? You
know, yeah,
and of course they say, well, yeah.
There's a human function of memory and problems. Like, if you don't feel bad today, you don't remember how you felt yesterday, you don't remember how bad it was, or you can remember you had a headache, or you can remember that you had spots in front of your eyes, but you can't feel that pain again. It's one of those things that God gave us to just wipe out that memory so we don't have to mull over it.
Right. So you have a checklist and an interview. You have the in-body and you have photographs.
Right.
So you can show somebody, this is what you looked like when you came in here four years ago.
Here's a mirror.
Yeah.
Look at yourself right now. Here's your picture when you came in.
Right.
And usually it's drastically different. Because when people really don't feel well and they don't have their hormones, they don't comb their hair. They may not put makeup on. They may not dress very well. They come back in and they're like, ta-da, I feel better. Mm-hmm. You know, they look different, but their faces also look healthier.
Right, and it's this total symptom addressing that you do at your practice that allows you to be able to say you have a 95% success rate. Your patients don't leave you, and they don't complain that this isn't helping.
Right, so. which is really nice, because that is a lot of the management of somebody who's taking hormones. Are you better? Are you not better? Are you better yesterday but not today? I mean, it doesn't change day by day. It changes 4 months at a time.
It is objective as well as subjective. You can ask me, how are you feeling? And I may say whatever I remember, whatever I'm aware of. But you track it with data, including blood tests. You get blood tests that show the consistent dosage over a month or 2 months or 3 months, so that you can track how much of it I'm using, how fast my reservoir is being depleted, and know when to intervene again, and put me on the right schedule so that I have a consistent response over time.
That's
I don't
right.
go up and down. I don't have those surges or crashes.
So when you test blood for somebody who's using vaginal tabs for estrogen or testosterone, oftentimes like a normal free testosterone free with a pellet for a woman would be about 15 to 25 or a little bit higher than that in some women to make their symptoms go away. And when I test the blood of somebody who's taking vag tabs, if I test it in the morning, that level is going to be 1,000.
Right.
But if I test it at night, it'll be 0. So that's the kind of thing that we see when other people bring their blood work in from using other forms of hormone.
Right.
So that's why that's why I like them, and that's why I use them only, because they're better. So the catch is you have to have a doctor who knows what they're doing and knows how to troubleshoot. So that's why we gave this lecture.
Right. And that also removes patient compliance issues. I don't have to remember, and I don't have to be good.
Right.
If I'm worried about compliance issues about diet or exercise or something, you can say, well, did you eat a lot of carbs over the weekend? I could lie to you, or I could say, yes, I did, or I have to remember and I have to do it. But with pellets, I don't have to remember anything about testosterone and estrogen.
You don't have to write down that some people have to take what time they took it.
And, yes.
And how much they took, and did they miss it that day? I mean, sometimes you just miss the whole day and then you're behind the eight ball. You've got to start over again.
Right.
So this is not what pellets do. It is a long-acting hormone, and it acts a lot like both testicles and ovaries act.
So. Well, like say, one of the things that you provide in addition to the hormone replacement therapy is some of your patients get peptides. And those peptides generally have to be refrigerated. And they have to remember to take
and
them.
And that's really hard.
Every day.
To always, well, you
be
have to
where
take
you
them.
Can get,
most of them
travel,
you have to take before bed.
Yeah.
Or you have to travel.
But
with
you have to remember
ice.
To do it. You,
yeah.
If you get really tired and exhausted, if you stay up late to watch the end of the ball game and then you go to bed and you didn't remember to take it, you're erratic over the course of a month. You might miss several days. And that impacts the benefit that you get from it.
Right. And so that's something I don't have as a pellet.
Right.
I have to use as a subcutaneous shot, like kind of like the shot you get used with insulin. So it's the same kind of shot you use it, you give it in the belly. So what we talked about for some of the issues, and I'm going to get through one of them probably. One issue with women who get testosterone pellets after years of not having any testosterone. So say they're 60 and their periods ended when they were 50, but their testosterone ends before that. So sometime in their 40s. So they haven't had testosterone in a long time. They haven't had a sex drive in a long time. They haven't had any kind of, I mean, they've probably turned down sexual activity, which is not good for the marriage. So when they get testosterone, I tell them, you may be hypersexual for the very first dose during, as soon as the level gets up to probably the second to third week, you're going to get hypersexual. So warn your partner, your husband, and tell him this is not going to last forever, but this is something that is going to happen and it will go away and it doesn't come back next time. It's because your receptor sites, the receivers of the testosterone in your body are all open, just waiting for just one little molecule of testosterone, and then you get enough. It bounces it up really fast. So then all of them fill, and they go, I've got testosterone.
So it's like visualizing a sponge that's dried out and withered, and then you put moisture in it, and it blossoms and opens. Those receptor sites get saturated in ways that they have not been for years, and that blows your libido up all of a sudden overnight, like blowing up a balloon. It's like, wow, I am ready. Come on.
Yeah.
And you're not used to that. Your partner's not used to that. You're afraid. I actually had a couple that I was seeing in a counseling practice that you were treating, and the wife had not had any sex drive for several years, and they were discussing that in counseling, and then they went to see you to get hormone treatment, and she called me like a week after she had seen you. And she said, I have this incredible state of arousal, and I just want to have sex all the time now, and I'm worried about, will the postman be safe if he comes to the house, you know? Will I be able to control
myself?
It's
just a couple weeks.
Yeah.
Just keep your head down.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what we told him. This is a one-time surge. It's short-lived. It'll go away. Once all those tissues get saturated, then that sponge isn't going to dry up and wither
again
because you have some in there. And so then you'll have what you remember as a normal libido, a libido that matches who you were before.
The goal is to get people back to what they were before in their 30s, and if they had children in their 30s to their late 20s, you know, so before all the life crashed in,
right.
Get your sex drive back to where it was that would keep your marriage together.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're looking for. We're not trying to do this, but there's no way to really avoid it. So we have to warn people, and so they aren't scared or they're not worried. But we write it, we tell them, we have it on the consents that partner, all of this can happen. And some people come in and go, I want to do it again. And I'm like, it doesn't happen again.
We have to wait 10 years. Yeah,
and then we can come back. We can do it again for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So
there are other initial first blush reactions that we will talk about in a later healthcast. But we just thought this one was of interest enough and important enough because so many women who have lost their libido have that initial reaction, but it is short-lived.
We wanted to reassure everybody that wasn't going to last. So thank you for listening, and hopefully you'll follow us next time, and we'll go through the rest of the initial issues that we have with pellets or any other hormone replacement.
All right. Thank you for listening.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth. Find Brett Newcomb at brettnewcomb.com.